scout here real quick. See what we're up against. There's an outside chance this might count towards our heads. I doubt it. Sounds like zombies. Yep, it's zombies. Let's do it. Just ending the turn. Hello, hello. Should be manageable. Take care of this lad and then move the whole group across to the left, I think. And I really want a big two-handed axe. Give to Lars. Fail. I don't want to be fighting up towards that high ground. Gotta be super careful with Thorium. He doesn't have a lot of hit points or a lot of armor. Super needs to do work on mission. Yeah, it said a stat roll at max rolls. Well, in any case, at the next level up on one of our low level nerds, we'll find out. I actually want that kettle helm helmet. Is this 19 armored Vadergangers? That's actually pretty damn tough. But if we spread them out and sort of milk it, it wouldn't be that bad. I think let's put the shield wall here. Oh yeah, I can hear those zombies as well. Perhaps I shouldn't be wasting that bit of ammo. Get him, Lars. Nice damage. I think we'll put the shield wall here in like a big U shape. Shields there, pikes, and yeah, that'll do. Everybody get into position, quickly. Oh, there's a bush there. Annoying. Okay, just here then. Ogh. Stupid bush. Who knows? I would think Mithril would be the strongest. Such a wonderfully nerd question. Is thorium harder than mithril or Hashtag nerd life. God love it. Man, I hope we get all these heads to claim. It'll give us the maximum of 35 we can hand in. I very much doubt it though. Shot. Actually need shields over here. There you go. Thorium, just I've got to be super careful with thorium. Oh, point blank and you miss, you suck. Come on, Nats, make some quick work of this guy here. Nerd world problems. Nice damage when you don't have a shield. That's 25 extra damage, but you're swinging twice, so that's 50% extra damage. Let's get Lord Skulder right in the middle of the group so he can use rally. Also keep an eye out for any good armor here. All of this is the like that armor is 110 for 10 fatigue, but this is 110 for 12 fatigue. I don't want any of this armor. Hello, disgusting zombie. Loving your work, lads. Loving your work. put you over here, probably. That's what I'm talking about. Hey, wait a second. The last time we fought 19 Vadergangers mixed with ghouls, we got this armor out of it, so we might actually get a decent haul here. Actually, yeah, we need to move Thorium. He's really on the tip of the spear there. That's not where he should be. He should be more to the side of one of the flanks. Seven. Great shooting. Ah, zombies are the worst. Fork wielder, come on. I expect more from you. Keep holding your position, Super. You'll get a target in no time. Don't you worry. Ugh, archer's letting us down now. Hold your position, Elwyn. You too, Lars. Good shooting. Nice little formation here. As soon as we put Francie there, we'll have a great little formation here. Oopsie, I forgot to reload. Okay, lads, time to start killing zombies. Good stabbing. Love it. Zombie at the back there. Good shooting. I think it's going to be important to maintain our formation and conserve fatigue by not using shield wall when we don't need to. That's wrong. Thorium should keep his shield up at all times. Worried about him. If I step forward, I can use swing here and hit all these three. Let's do it. It means we have to adjust the formation slightly, but that was great. Prioritize the guy who has the spear, because the spear is so much more dangerous. Big bugger. Yep. Wonder if it's not time to go to... Yeah, it's time to go to his pike after this next shot. Getting properly swarmed here. Not too scary though. Nice work. Ouchie. First bit of damage. Hildebert, what are your 1663? Take the 51% shot, I reckon. Damn it. Ah, oh, Jamar was supposed to go to his pike. Okay, next turn. Oh, so close. Thorium, shield up. Take a swing. Damn it. Oh, almost no damage. Love it. Armor is so wonderfully tough. Pretty big swing. Yes. That's why great swords are so good. Okay, that's a problem. Decapitation, love it. He's not gonna raise up from that. Ah, come on. Erling, you should go to your pike. That actually hurt a little bit. Out of arrows. Sweet. Keep shooting. Ow. Hildebert. 248 is probably fine. Okay, we got a problem here with Alwyn. He's got to keep his shield up now, I reckon. Needs a bit of help and reinforcement. Delmore. Pike time. Good hit, good shot, good shot. Oh, exhausted. Big swing. I love that ability, it's so good. Promise he's exhausted now. Oh, seriously? Now it's gonna eat someone, god damn it. Kill that zombie stat. Oh, damn it. He better not eat Super Duper. I will be annoyed. Crap. Crap. Healed a bit. Time to go your hooked blade, I reckon. I know that puts you into melee with this guy, but... Ah! Oh, everyone's exhausted. This is hell. Oh, now we keep missing it. Yeah, it's gonna eat someone. Damn it. You have to kill the guy that ate him. Now that does a nice bit of damage towards it. Helps. There's so many of these bloody zombies. At least they do nothing against that armor. Oh, that didn't do a lot. Oh god! Oi! He's attacking! Not eating. Okay, thank goodness. Okay, good, he's almost down. Bastard. Elwyn, go reinforce the southern flank. It's a lot tougher than I was expecting. Oh, the fatigue's a problem. I wonder if I shouldn't take recover on some of the guys. Oh my god. Yeah, for these long fights, I think you need recover. These bastards just keep coming back. Oh! Missed. Missed. Everyone's exhausted. It's like, oh my god, we're so unfit. Yeah, we're almost there. Oh, for God's sake. Pikes. We should get loads of XP from this. We did a lot of damage. Good, he's fleeing. Whew. You get around him. Get him. Look at all the XP, that's huge. 200 XP for super. Oh, yes. That's just money, but. Oh, we got the maximum, it counted towards the heads. Oh, yeah. Oh, we're gonna be so rich. But guys, what's 35 times 70? 2,370? Very successful patrol. 2,400. Meddling with nobles. Our first achievement. Complete a contract for a noble house. And we should get loads of money for all the stuff that we got. Let's buy that big two-handed axe. Oh, I've been waiting to do this a long time. Oh yes, great axe time. Or two-handed hammer. Nah, it's gotta be the great axe. Oh, we've done it. We've done it, lads. Oh yes. Inflicts 180 to 225 armor damage. That's amazing. Round swing is cool, 36 damage to shields. At the next level he'll take Axe Mastery or plus 50% more shield damage. So that 36 will be turned into 50 something. So he'll be able to easily one shot a heater shield. Two shot a big shield like that and one shot a kite shield. Oh, this is so good. Everybody else can also start picking a weapon specialization. So here we're gonna go X specialization. Francie, she's got high defense. I kind of want to go sword mastery on her. Well, no, she's gonna go for cleaver mastery. Beldun is a tank, so he'll go sword mastery. Flail mastery here. And I think Alwyn needs to be a... he's also a tank, so he's going to go sword mastery as well. I'd also love to get that long axe. But there's no space for it. We can start saving for armor now, like male hauberks or... What's our next goal anyway, like armor and weapon-wise? Weapon-wise, we're pretty much where we want to be. I mean, if I want to be difficult, I could always get four more of these long axes for the archers. So that if they're not shooting, they're breaking spears. Shields, excuse me. We are not using these throwing weapons, but should we get rid of them? I'm tempted to get rid of them. We're never using them. Just taking up space. No, don't need that. Don't need that. Or that. Black Watch from Goldbill, well, remember. Nothing, alright. I was hoping for more hints towards some layers that we can go to. Need a temple. There's a temple. Arkenstadt. Running out of time. We've got 52 days still. But we still need to get a famed weapon and a famed helmet. Ah, man, I can't wait to see those two-handed axes in action. I might even get a third person, one of the tanks, to become a hammer specialist and get a two-handed hammer on him. Oh, no wounded. Okay, it looks like the cut artery healed itself. Do I need any of this stuff particularly? Not really, we got loads of food. I could look for a recruit. We might need to look at getting some alternates, some backups. Ulf the Thief. Not quite yet. If I find a person who I really want, like a brawler, I might do, but... no. What is this? No thanks. What is this? Caravan guarded, no thanks. Two skulls. Greenskins. Camp west from here. Two skull orcs is too much for us. Let's not get ahead of ourselves. I'll only take on a two-skull orc mission once I have shield mastery and weapon mastery on all of my guys on the front line. Already got the shield mastery, but not quite the weapon mastery. I tell you what, I want to go clear out this necromancer's lair. It's just, it's armored Vedagangas. It's one necromancer. And that's it, really, I think. And one fallen hero, yeah. And if anything's going to give us a famed weapon or helmet or armor, it'll be there. Just got to make sure that we can find that necromancer. And with the falcon, I'm pretty sure we'll be able to do so. Oh, hello, we've got some tracks here. Wild beasts, maybe some zombies that we can get some, grind some XP on. Hello, hello. Necro savants, what are those? Many auxiliaries. What the hell is a necro savant? I don't want to find out just yet. I follow these tracks first, see what we can find. The tracks are getting fresh. It, look, that's doable. It really is. Hope it's not dire wolves. That's vampires, so some vampires. Whoa, that's a huge group, whatever it is, it's huge. Look at the size of that footprint. 11 Nachtseers, let's get them. Just don't want to fight them in the forest. This will be awesome amounts of XP for us. Let's try something a touch different. I wonder if these guys should be on the flanks or whether they should be like that more. No, they should be on the flanks, and it's easier to get them space so they can swing in huge circles. 11 zombies, let's get them. We can actually, I think we can take that. I mean, if it's some vampires, it's like four of them. And as long as our guys on the back lines start with nets out, we can net them, chop them up. But then there's still a lot of those auxiliaries to deal with. They're pretty scary. I'm definitely going to put Lars out in the middle so he can swing his axe in a big circle. Oh, yes. Man, having four archers is just the business. Gunner, you can just wait. Stay where you are, chaps. Raise morale. It wasn't orc auxiliaries, it was necromants. What they're like, not orc, they skeletons. Skeleton auxiliaries. I kind of want to put Lars up there, so height advantage. If they want to swarm him, they're welcome to. They'll get. They'll all get round swung. Love it. We should actually be moving forward and covering the corpses so that they can't feast. Keep surrounding him, come on. Oh. It's not very often that you actually want your guys to be surrounded. The archers are doing such work. Oh, bad. Unlucky. Hits the other guy accidentally. Love it. Such a good job. Such a good work. Double kill! Our boys are getting quite powerful now. Feasting! Can you be Elwyn? Certainly. Oh, come on, Gunnar. Super duper, get this nerd. Oh, look at the damage. How much damage did that do? 160. Man. Actually, the next huge purchase for me should be war bows, those huge bows for the backline, and huge crossbows as well. They'll do so much with them. We're making mincemeat of these things. Awesome, it's fleeing. Oh, so much damage. Any level ups? No. You want to be Elwyn. Who's Elwyn? Elwyn, Elwyn, Elwyn. Oh, there he is. Kalgatla. This is Kalgatla the second, I believe. You are a tank. You guys want to get involved? Lars is available. Actually, I think I need to make that. I would say Lord Skulder, but he's already in. He's always wanted to be a big two-handed guy. Let's make this Sugarstalker the butcher. Let's see. So Baldwin is available. Hjalmar is available. Hildebert's available. Erling's available, and Gunnar is available. You lads would like to get involved? I think we can take this one on, that necromancer's crypt thing. I'm gonna need my archers to get some advantage here. So lots of Vedagangers, armored Vedagangers, 8 of them, not too dangerous. Only one fallen hero and only one necromancer. We'll take this on in the morning. Make sure all of our archers have their bows and arrows out. Yes, they do. Excellent. So it's going to be important that our two-handed axe is placed onto that fallen hero so that we can smash his shield. Because the fallen hero is almost certain to have... Oh god, that's a lot more than I thought! Okay, so... We need to move generally towards this way so we can start laying down arrows onto that necromancer. And once we've got the necromancer, I shouldn't be too worried about the Vedagangers. No, I'm not going to shoot. We're going to start moving. 1, 2, 3, 4. That's actually fine. I don't mind that. Man, having the falcon is so useful. Just hope he doesn't run away. That means he's had the necromancers controlling him. He moves further. He attacks twice. I doubt we'll be able to take the high ground here, but if we can, that'll be wonderful. So that's going to be Super and Sugar taking care of that fallen hero. Damn it. But no, the main thing is to get my archers into a position where they can start shooting at that necromancer. Okay, cool. So hired a militia with Brave and 3 stars in melee. So was he called like something the Brave? That's pretty cool. I must start thinking about that type of stuff on the guys that I hire. If someone is in militia and he has the Brave, hungry for more fighting. Cool. Yeah, that's worth being worried about, honestly. On the next turn, our archers can hopefully make mincemeat of that necromancer. I'm worried about the southern flank, though. I'm going to need Gunnar to break shields and do some damage generally. 42%. Get him, Forkwielder. Oh. It's gonna take forever to kill that necromancer. Do I use frenzy? No. Let's rather raise morale. The archers will take it, that necromancer eventually. Nice! Mike, sure, you can take Gunner, this gigantic sword wielding badass. Move up, Jalmar. I need all my archers focusing on that necromancer. Good damage. Good damage. God, this thing's tough. When they're possessed, they are super, super tough. Now I use footwork to get to the high ground. Let's experiment. Sweet. The fatigue cost is unfortunate, but that was well worth it, I think. You guys are going down. If only that was our two-handed axe user. Thorium's in trouble. He needs to keep his shield up at all times, I think. Stop protecting the necromancer, you bastards! I need that guy to move. He is making it more difficult to hit the necromancer. Oh, good. We need to just take a couple more shots. Oh, so close. Crap. Oh, one more shot. Come on. Big swing. Oh, yes. Let's focus on this guy here with the sword. Oh, the miss. That sucks. Keep getting closer. Come on. Oh, almost. I'm pretty sure we can take him out next turn when you go stop worrying about this fallen hero. Oh god, Thorium's in huge trouble. Rip Thorium. Getting in the way of the Necromancer. Yeah, rip Thorium. He's friggin' dead. Yeah, that's also a problem. I need one of my tough guys to go toe-to-toe with that fallen hero. Struck down, not dead. Ah, almost. I need to start working on that oh, sweet, he one-shot the shield. Good. Come on, one of these are going to hit. Well, it's not the one I wanted, but... I bet you get brain damage. Make a break for it, Francie. That frickin' necromancer is being such a ball bag. I didn't kill any of them, but essentially triple damage. I am a bit worried about his head armor not holding up. 76, 86. I think we go for the 70 and hopefully kill this possessed one. Ah, almost. So, body hit for 60, head hit for 37. What sucks the most is that this fallen hero has a morning star, so he's going to exhaust whoever hits. Gunnar is going to have a hard time staying alive. Come on! Ah! Hell. Finally, okay, that's huge. That is huge. Whoever you can hit that is the lowest hit points, kill whatever you can. Release the hound. This is desperation. Yeah, Gunnar is not going to survive this full-on hero attacking him. We're running out of armor in a hurry here. Oh! Super scary. Chigo, quickly bandage yourself. You're bleeding. Sweet. Bandage your wound. See, I don't want to go there because then he can be attacked from high cover. I'd rather let him rest and then on the next turn go to that position. Oh, Francie. Good work. I'm so worried about what this fallen hero is going to do. Who's wounded? Who's wounded? This guy's wounded. Yeah, arrows aren't going to do very much, but it's better than nothing, I suppose. 47s. Who's low enough to die in one shot? This guy is. Ah, oh, guys, you can't afford to miss. It's going to cost a fortune to repair all this armor, and Super's armor is about to go down. Worth noting, we need to start being careful about Super. Super can't go down, we'll lose that armor if he dies. Get decapitated! Ouch! God, this is a hell of a fight. Tiny was scratching away at him slowly. Easy. Watch where you're shooting. Okay, here we go. Jiggerstalker. You're gonna take that fallen hero down. These two big axes should make short work of him. All the shields we've had, I think, have been great. It's made a huge difference. Oh, that's so scary. Almost. Okay, I think we've done it. We've mostly done it. Ah, good damage. Let's look at the damage values there. Fallen hero's body armor hit for 58. Armor destroyed. Body hit for 40. Head armor hit for 51. Man, this two-handed sword is axe is amazing. I think I prefer the sword though, because you can more precisely hit multiple targets from being in a battle line, you know? Oh god! Oh! And I was in super loads of trouble. We might be able to knock that fallen hero back. Actually, Super, yeah, you can still fight him. You've got some body armor. Oh, god damn it. Struck down, Gunner. Out of ammo. Go to your pike. Surround this fallen hero. Never mind, it's nearly dead. The two of our guys got struck down. Sweet. Kill a fallen hero. Okay, so no deaths, but we did get two guys struck down, and depending on what their injuries are, they might have to get retired. I have a suspicion that we're going to have to retire Thorium. This is going to be his third permanent injury. I think we're going to have to retire him. Hope for just brain damage. Oh, he's half in the ground. Interesting. God, this was a hell of a fight. Everyone's exhausted. But the two-handed axe and the two-handed sword just did work. Oh, he comes back! Never mind. Oh! What a fight. So, missing ear, that's fine. Traumatized, resolve, that's not necessarily the end of the world. Ooh, decayed full helm. No, but for 20 fatigue, that's far too much. I was really hoping for a unique item of some sort. Let's take a look at Thorium. Look at this. Weakened heart and traumatized. I think we can keep him. Not the end of the world yet. We'll just take Fortified Mind as his next ability. Sergeant Frenzy. Rotation, probably. No, Cleaver Mastery. I don't have a cleaver for her to use yet, though. What do we have for her to use? Not a spear, not daggers, not swords. I want to go cleaver. The flail mastery could be good. Mace mastery, 67. I think let's go for mace mastery. And we'll just hang on to the next mace that we get. Don't we have one? No, they're fairly easy to get. So sergeant, mace master, Francie. Mix master Francie. Hit points and resolve, because she is a sergeant, so no, she needs more fatigue. Scold is our main sergeant. This is missing an ear. Who wanted to be gunner? It was Thorium. No. XVX Mike. XVX Mike. VX. What are you exactly? You're just going to be a shield bearer at some point. We're going to see how gifted works. This is the first normal roll. We'll take plus 3 there, we'll take 3 there, and we'll take 4 there. And then there's the gifted roll. Seems to be pretty much the same. Yeah, don't think it's worth it. Yeah, I would much rather have had Colossus keep him safe, but I suppose there's arguments for and against it. Okay, so now four wielder. What can he take offensively that'll help him? Don't really know. I think it's probably just time for him to take anticipation, keep him safe from the enemy's archers shooting at him. Keep taking range defense. Oh, he's got this range skill. Amazing. Yeah, I don't understand quite how that resolve roll works. If I can afford a tier 3 mace, I'll buy one for Francie. I reckon she'll do work with it. Problem is, they cost about 3 grand. Nice. Randomly no longer suffers from sprained ankle. Where is a tier 3 mace? I don't know. Let's just buy a Morningstar. I really want Francie to use a Morningstar. And she can guaranteed stun someone. I think that's worth it. Who needs their wounds treated? Cut arm is fine. Military cleaver, maybe, and then I make one of the guys a cleaver master. Master of flails. Master of mace. The butcher. Huskarl, although Huskarl doesn't really work. I think Highlander is a cool name for a two-handed sword user. The Kogartler. Or Balduin will be using Butcher Cleaver Mastery, but they don't really have the... Okay, Balduin could do. So, Master of Cleaver. Whoops. Well, once we can get him a cleaver, that is. And he'll be leveling up very soon, getting cleaver. Bleeding damage doubled to 10 per turn. That's actually pretty damn good. Master of Flails. And then Kolgata will be Master of Sword. Cool, so Butcher, Mace, Cleaver, Flails, Swords, Highlander. And you've got an X. Well, okay, I'll tell you what. The backline guys can be changed to be called Shield Breakers because that's their primary role. I might even have Lord Skulder get a two-handed axe and then just carry the battle standard. Honestly, it's more important that he breaks shields for the guys on the front lines to just go to work. Temple. We don't need swords, we don't need any more flails or one-handed axes. Hell, I can actually buy that cleaver now. I can afford it. Sweet. Elduin, Master of Cleaver. That's fucking so cool. Shifting, Fraggle Jim. You can take Hildebert, who's an archer, or you can take Erling, who's a crossbowman. Or Hjalmar, who's a crossbowman. So you've got your choice of two crossbowmen with 50 skill, 49 crossbowmen, or 58 archer. Look at the daily rate, almost 200, wow. Archer for sure, no problem, buddy. Greggle Jim the Archer. That's Mike. Okay, everyone, Erling is still available. Jelmar is available. And Baldwin's available. Master of Cleaver, that's going to be so cool. Look at that, inflicts 40 to 120 depending on how injured the target already is. That's going to be amazing. Doesn't do much against... Oh, 90% effective against armor. Okay. And then once we upgrade that to a winged mace, that's going to be even better. The best thing is Knockout has 100% chance to stun if it's not immune. That's going to be so big for us. What is this contract? Some goblins, no thanks. That's still a bit much. Let's go get a temple and get ourselves healed and set. We'll head back out here into the west. Or potentially we should take on the vampires and skeletons, which I think is probably a good bet. And it's a fairly good chance to give us a maimed weapon or helmet, which is what we need. What the hell? Are you being attacked? Arkenstedt. Put the fire out. Come on. Weird. Ooh. Price is lucky. They're okay. Alright. Let's take a little break. I've been streaming for, I think, 12 hours today. I need to stop. Die. Yeah, I think we'll probably take this, Undead, Tension, Dunkinvold. How many crowns? 14, okay, it can't be very far. Where's Dunkinvold? It's just up the road, okay. Well, we'll accept it, so I know that I have a mission to do when we come back. That's it for me, guys. Alright. Thanks for watching. When we come back, we'll be doing deliveries to Dunkinvold, and we're going to keep clearing out ruins to see if we can find a famous helmet or a famous weapon.